Welcome to South Asia Today, a show that provides you the glimpses of South Asia. I'm your host Yeshi. Here are the headlines. India's NMCG develops infrastructure to stop sewage water flowing into Ganga. Yamaha introduces environment-friendly e-bike for adrenaline junkies. And devotees in Nepal begin New Year celebrations. US President Joe Biden has come up with a fresh withdrawal date for US troops from Afghanistan. 11 September, with its historical and symbolical significance, is the day when US forces will leave Afghan soil permanently. The decision comes after Biden conceded that it was tough for his administration to withdraw by May 1st, the deadline set during the deal signed between the Taliban and the previous Donald Trump administration.
The United States will begin our final withdrawal.
The US President Joe Biden declared this week that he doesn't plan to further extend what already is the longest US war. His decision comes in line with Washington widening its efforts and intent to bring back its troops from two decades of the protracted war that has claimed tens of thousands of lives of both civilians and security forces. As per the new plan, the drawdown will begin from May 1, the date earlier scheduled for complete withdrawal of troops, and it will be over by 11th of September. None amongst the current strength of 2,500 US troops will stay post the date.
I'm now the fourth United States president to preside over American troop presence in Afghanistan. Two Republicans, two Democrats. I will not pass this responsibility onto a fifth. After consulting closely with our allies and partners, with our military leaders and intelligence personnel, with our diplomats, and our development experts, with the Congress and the Vice President, as well as with Mr. Ghani and many others around the world, I've concluded that it's time to end America's longest war. It's time for American troops to come home.
Meanwhile, NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said that foreign troops under NATO command will also withdraw from Afghanistan in coordination with the US pullout. Currently, around 7,000 non-US forces from mainly NATO countries and from Australia, New Zealand and Georgia are stationed in Afghanistan. NATO-led Resolute Support is in Afghanistan to train and equip Afghan security forces fighting the Islamist Taliban that has made significant resurgence in past few years.
In the light of the US decision to withdraw, foreign and defense ministers of NATO discussed the way forward today and decided that we will start the withdrawal of NATO Resolute Support mission forces by May 1st. Our drawdown will be orderly, coordinated, and deliberate. We plan to complete the drawdown for all our troops within a few months.
Non-NATO and non-US forces too will be leaving Afghanistan in next 5 months. Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison said that the war had already rendered heavy losses to Australian forces in Afghanistan. While NATO exit might have made it mandatory for Aussies to leave, observers say such decisions were always being considered in Canberra ever since their troops were found guilty of civilian killings.
But safeguarding Afghanistan's security has come at a great cost to Australia. Since 2001, 41 Australian personnel have lost their lives while serving in Afghanistan, and many more were wounded, some physically, others mentally, and will be dealing with the scars, both mental and physical, of their service for many, many years.
The United States has drafted a peace plan calling for the current Afghan government to be replaced with an interim administration until a new constitution is agreed and elections held. All stakeholders had agreed to accelerate the peace process in recently held summit in Russian capital Moscow. But things are appearing to hit another roadblock as Ghani is not ready for transitional government without elections. The next meeting of regional players is scheduled in Turkey in a few days, which Taliban has decided to boycott, and now the major players are concerned as to how things will move forward if everybody is not on the same page.
Moving on, rivers have a profound religious significance in the Indian society. River Ganga is considered as a goddess in Hindu religion. Today, we will take you to the India's temple town of Haridwar, where the National Mission of Clean Ganga has been tirelessly working on ensuring that pilgrims get to see a cleaner Ganga with no flow of sewage water. They recently developed infrastructure to stop sewage water floating in the holy river. Have a look.
An ancient city located on the banks of River Ganga, Haridwar is expanding rapidly. Being a popular pilgrimage site, the city also witnesses a massive floating population as each day pilgrims come to bathe at the holy river to get rid of their sins. The number of visitors grow manifold during the festivals, especially month-long Kumbh Fair. The National Mission for Clean Ganga has been tirelessly endeavouring to ensure that pilgrims get a cleaner Ganga at this holy site with no flow of sewage water. It has intercepted all major and minor sources of river pollution under the Namami Gange program.
We added lots of new projects in Sarai, in Jagjitpur, and now 145 MLD capacity is very much there in Haridwar, and 115 MLD is actually being used. So we are fully geared up in Haridwar to meet any kind of sewerage pollution, not even for the present load, but even for the future. Similarly, any flow coming from the Rishikesh side or Munikireti, so all those projects have also been completed, and few months back Honorable PM inaugurated all those projects. So one thing is we have kept Haridwar fully prepared to meet any kind of pollution load and keep River Ganga free from raw sewage entering into the river.
The key projects in Haridwar have included intercepting major drains falling into the river and diverting them to sewage treatment plants. Kasavan Nala, one of the biggest drains that would contaminate the river severely, has been tapped entirely and diverted to the STP.
There was a very notorious, infamous Kasavan Nala, which could have been seen by people, you know, when they were going from Delhi towards Haridwar. That Kasavan Nala, which used to drain sewage, draw sewage into Ganga about in the couple of years back, that has been completely stopped, and no sewage is now going into Haridwar and in even upper reaches in Uttarakhand in the river Ganga. So that is the kind of preparation which we have done for upcoming Kumbh.
Inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the tech-equipped expansion of 68 MLD STP at Jagjitpur is instrumental in treating the sewage load that compounds during the massive festive gatherings like Kumbh. Built at a cost of 230 crore, the STP achieved its current strength a few months ago. Another 40 MLD STP at Sarai, developed a little over a year ago under the hybrid annuity model, will add to the comprehensive campaign of protecting and rejuvenating the river. The Kasavan Nala sewage is also treated at Sarai only.
दो बड़े एसटीपी 68 एमएलडी एसटीपी जगजीतपुर और 14 एमएलडी एसटीपी सराय नमामि गंगे में पूरे किए। इसके अलावा 5 नाला टैपिंग, जो पुरानी टैप नाले से 17 उनकी क्षमता वृद्धि और ये सारे कार्य संपादित करेंगे। तो कुंभ मेले में आप अवगत होंगे हरिद्वार में कुंभ मेला भी होता है समय समय पर, कांवड़ मेला और पूर्णमासी मेला, इस तरह के मेले लगातार चलते रहते हैं, फ्लोटिंग पॉपुलेशन आती है। तो इस प्रकार हमारे पास इस समय हरिद्वार में 145 एमडी शोधन क्षमता पूरी हो गई है, जो किसी भी प्रकार से कुंभ मेले में या किसी अन्य पर्व पर जो हमारी फ्लोटिंग पॉपुलेशन आती है उसे कैटर करने के लिए पर्याप्त है।
जो हमारा फिल्टर करने का जो हो रहा है फिलिंग और इरेशन में, वो एयर द्वारा हो रहा है, एयर के द्वारा हमको हम फिल्टर करते हैं उसको, फिर उसके बाद देन सेटल होता है, सेटल से फिर हम थिकनर में लेते हैं, स्लज थिकनर हमको दिया हुआ है, उससे फिर हम क्लियर वाटर तो हमारा सीसीटी से आउटलेट होकर क्लोरीन मिक्स करते हैं उसमें, रेजिडेंस क्लोरीन उसको मिक्स करके जिससे बैक्टीरिया को मार सकें जो थोड़ा बहुत रह जाता है, तो उसके लिए क्लोरीन यूज़ करते हैं और फिर आउट कर देते हैं।
To the Hindus, the Ganga is a sacred river, and any town or city on its banks is believed to be blessed. Haridwar is a paradise for the pilgrims who throng the ghats of the river to attain Nirvana. The Government of India, through the National Mission for Clean Ganga, has not just been providing a cleaner and conducive holy site to them, but working in larger interest of all inhabitants along the course of the river.
Now we take a look at some happenings in Asia in a segment called Asia Watch.
Japan plans to release into the sea more than 1 million tons of contaminated water from the destroyed Fukushima nuclear station. The government said a decision that is likely to anger neighbors such as South Korea. The move, more than a decade after the nuclear disaster, will deal another blow to the fishing industry in Fukushima, which has opposed such a step for years. The Fukushima plant operates Tokyo Electric Power plants to filter the contaminated water again to remove isotopes leaving only tritium, a radioactive isotope of hydrogen hard to separate from water. TEPCO will then dilute the water until tritium levels fall below regulatory limits before pumping it directly into the ocean from the coastal site. The disposal of contaminated water from the Fukushima Daiichi plant run by Tokyo Electric Power has proved a thorny problem for Japan as it pursues a decades-long decommissioning project. Air pollution, exacerbated by some of Nepal's worst forest fires in years, continue to reach hazardous levels in the Himalayan nation's capital of Kathmandu. Wildfires have been burning across Nepal, adding to the growing levels of pollution across the country that lies nestled between India and China. 5 people have died so far trying to put out the fires that have been raging since January. Dust from construction works, exhaust from old, poorly maintained vehicles, and smoke from coal-burning brick kilns blend in a murky haze that hangs over the ancient city of 4 million people, also are factors responsible for the rise in air pollution. Nepal ordered schools off close for 4 days at the end of March after air pollution climbed to hazardous levels, forcing millions of students to stay home. Japanese Prime Minister Yoshihide Suga is set to meet US President Joe Biden. The two leaders are expected to present a united front of Taiwan, China's most sensitive territorial issue. According to a senior US official who said Suga and Biden plan to put out a joint statement on preserving the status quo in the self-governed Taiwan, a democratic island which Beijing claims as its own. It's Biden's first in-person meeting with a foreign leader as he seeks to relocate US military and diplomatic resources to the Indo-Pacific in an effort to counter China's growing power. Biden and Suga are also set to discuss Beijing's treatment of Muslims in Xinjiang and its tightening grip on Hong Kong, while announcing a $2 billion Japanese investment in 5G telecommunications to counter China's Huawei. The summit comes a day after several of Biden's emissaries met with Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen, pledging to work together to deter the threat of heightened Chinese military activity. But the joint statement of Taiwan is likely to fall short of the US expectations as Japan struggles to balance its deep economic ties with China and navigate frosty relations with fellow US allies South Korea. Relations between Tokyo and Seoul have frayed over issues connected to Japan's former colonization of Korea.
Japan produces high-quality products that have gained traction across the globe. Recently, Yamaha introduced an electric bike for adrenaline junkies to provide excellent opportunities to enjoy sport and keep the environment clean. On the other side, Panasonic has come up with a new agricultural technology with advanced functions. We have a report.
In a changing global scenario, the healthy and safe transportation has accelerated the movement of riding bicycles. Mountain biking is a thrilling sport that is loved by many adrenaline junkies. It is a great way to experience the outdoors and nature in a fun and exciting way. Yamaha has decided to use its expertise of making both motorbikes and e-bikes to create new mountain flagship e-bike.
This model is 今まで便利材っていうような電動自転車ではなくて乗って楽しむというものになっておりまして、今回発表させていただきましたのは前後にサスペンションを持ったよりスポーティーなフラッグシップモデルというのが特徴になります。An
outdoor event was held to showcase new mountain e-bike models as well as give guests a chance to test ride these bikes and experience the off-road adventure. The great thing about these bikes is that even those who haven't done mountain biking before can experience the fun with the help of electric drive unit.
こちらのモデルの特徴なんですけども、ハイスペックな、マウンテンバイクに、e バイクの要素。こちらの方、フロントサスペンションに加えて新たに、弊社では初めてなんですけども、リアにも、クッションをつけてきております。で、過去のモデルなんかよりもかなり、このクッションのストロークですね、長めのものを用意しておりますので、よりハードな、路面のところへ行っていただいても安定した走りを、得られることができます。
The interest in mountain biking has been on the rise since mountain bike cross country was added to Olympics. Bicycle riding has become more popular since then.
発売当初、1993年から発売しましたけれども、その当初はですね、主に高齢者のお客様がメインのお客様でした。で、その後ですね、主婦層を中心として、もうちょっと若い世代に広がってきました。で、現在はですね、通勤通学といったさらにヤングの層に広がっておりまして、こういうユーザーの広がりそのものが市場の広がりになって、市場がどんどん拡大しているというものでございます。地球環境問題というのがありまして、ヨーロッパを中心に電動化というものがかなり進んでいると思います。これに向かって我々のこの電動足と自転車、CO2 の排出係数が非常に小さくなっておりますので、可能性があるんじゃないかと期待しております。
Japanese technology is adding comfort to daily life. It provides excellent opportunity to enjoy sport and keep environment clean. Next, we take you to Ishigaki Island. It is located in southwestern Japan and is famous for its Emerald Sea and amazing nature. Although monsoon has been a hard challenge for agriculture here, the island now has delicious fresh vegetables and fruits to enjoy the cool climate.
こちらはですね、アジアモンスーン植物工場システムという、プロジェクトで、建てた栽培ハウスということになります。で、こちらの方は、日本語で言うと担当ハウスと言ってるんですか、いわゆるかまぼこ型とですね、細長い、いわゆるビニールハウスという形になっています。しかしながら中はですね、かなりハイテクないわゆる環境制御と呼ばれるものがありまして、それがまたクラウドですね、につながってですね、日本のどこからでも、もっと言うと世界離れたとこからでもですね、この中の状態を知ることができて、しかも環境制御ですね。環境制御あってみていただきますが、そういうことができるという仕組みが入っています。
It is equipped with a real-time monitoring system, CO2, humidity, and light sensors. Also, high-pressure mist for cooling all controlled with the help of computer.
こちらの方がですね、トマトを栽培しているところになります。ご覧いただけますかね、一部かなり赤く実っております。品種は滝種苗さんの桃太郎ホープという品種になりまして、で通常は10アールあたりですね、いくらということで、この石垣島の我々の実証試験では10アールあたり40トン取れるというふうな結果が出ます。今度はイチゴを栽培しているハウスになります。イチゴはトマトに比べてですね、より高い温度が苦手、涼しい温度を好む、そういう作物になりますので、こちらは先ほどのトマトよりもさらに冷やす工夫というのをしています。今ちょうどこのミストがかかってきました。たくさんのイチゴを取るためにはですね、いわゆる光、光合成を活発化させるために光も必要なんですが、しかし光をあまり入れすぎるとこの熱くなるということで、こちらは特に新しい挑戦としてLED を使った歩行ですね、光を補うもの、こういうものを使っております。
A seminar was held to introduce technologies that achieve cultivation of Japanese fresh fruits and vegetables in hot and humid areas all year round by using a cloud-based integrated environmental control system. And Southeast Asian country representatives attended and later joined the field trip.
Kind of technology. That's why I asked about the feasibility of the investment and also the dissemination level of the GIRCAS technology to the public.
Plant factory type intelligent greenhouses can solve many agriculture challenges and provide delicious results.
Moving on to Nepal, where festivals and fairs are celebrated in a unique way. Each community respects and enjoys the culture of other communities. Recently, Biska Jatra was celebrated in Nepal's Bhaktapur city. Devotees flocked to Taumadi Square to take part in the ritual, where the idol of Lord Bhairav was carried to the chariot and devotees were indulged in a tug-of-war. Have a look. A large number of devotees gathered in Bhaktapur to celebrate the arrival of New Year with chariot festival. Amid COVID-19, the people flocked to the Taumadi Square to take part in the Biska Jatra fair, where idol of Lord Bhairav was carried to the chariot. The three-story chariot made of wood in pagoda style is pushed and pulled around the settlements with the statues of Bhairav Nath and Betal as a part of this festival.
खटमा लागेर अब त्यहाँ यसो गर्छ तल एकखेर लान्छ माथि लान्छ होइन फेरि उता उता रहेपछि त्यहाँ राख्छ तल त्यहाँ राख्छ त्यसमा
द बिस्क जात्रा फेस्टिभल इज सेलिब्रेटेड फर 9 डेज एन्ड 8 नाइट्स इट इज द ओन्ली फेस्टिभल द्याट डज नट फलो द लुनर बेस्ड नेपाली क्यालेन्डर ड्युरिङ द फेस्टिभल The Taumadi Square was packed with revelers and devotees who came here to participate in their annual event Biska Jatra. On the eve of Nepali New Year, a large pole is erected and two long pieces of cloth hanged upon it to represent the dead snakes. The next day, the pole is pulled down and Nepali New Year officially commences. According to legends, this celebration is the festival after the death of the serpent.
Biskit baneko niwar bhashale biskit sarpa mareko jata biskit jata biskit baneko sarpa le mareko tei marera euta tha tyo tya lingo uthaune tham cha tya le ra tyo हलिमपट भन्छ त्यो बिस्केकै जात्रा भनेको त्यही सर्प काटेर त्यसको सबैले देख्नेले त्यो राख्यो
द सेलिब्रेसन समिट द पेन्डेमिक रिफ्लेक्ट द स्ट्रङ फेथ अफ पिपल इन नेपाल टु प्रिजर्भ देयर ट्रेडिसन्स एन्ड रिचुअल्स इट्स टाइम फर मी टु रैप अप टुडेज एपिसोड वी विल बी ब्याक नेक्स्ट विक एट द सेम टाइम This is Yeshi signing off on behalf of the entire production team of South Asia Today. Goodbye and take care.